Hello and welcome all. Today we are going to see how a crystal radio is working. This is the simple circuit of a crystal radio. Here we can say that two coils are wounded and this is a tuned circuit. It consists of an inductor and a capacitor. We can change the value of the inductor by moving this is a sliding contact. By moving this sliding contact, we can change the value of the inductance. That means if we move like this towards left or right, we can change the number of turns. As we change the number of turns, the value of the inductance will be changed. And we have a capacitor and we can change the value of the capacitance also. So as we know that to get a resonant frequency, that means the frequency at which we can get the maximum output, that is called resonant frequency. By giving the equation 1 by 2 pi root LC, we can select a desired frequency. Then if we say that this is used to select an amplitude modulated signal, that means the different radio stations broadcast their signals at different frequencies. So say if it is 750 kilohertz or 1000 kilohertz or 1200 kilohertz, at different frequencies they are sending the signals. Sending the signals means if we say that this is the voice signal, this will be a very low signal. And if we want to transmit this signal, what we do is that if we say that a station with a frequency, they are allowing a frequency of 750 kilohertz. So when this station is broadcasting, what they do is they take the message signal and we modulate with a 750 kilohertz carrier frequency, that they are allowed. When modulating this message signal with carrier frequency, we get a frequency that's amplitude is varying according to the message signal and the frequencies remains the same. That means the frequency is not changing. And another station, if we say that 1000 kilohertz, they are broadcasting at the 1000 kilohertz, when they are sending the signal at the same signal at 1000 kilohertz, that means be at a higher frequency but sending the same signal. When both signal arrive at this point, both signal will be gone through this. When 1000 kilohertz is coming at this circuit, this will produce a magnetic flux. When this magnetic flux is linked with this coil, this will ask, we are tuned this circuit at 750 kilohertz, that means at 750 kilohertz only this will produce a high voltage. At all other frequencies, this voltage at this point will be very low. Why? So because at 1000 kilohertz this will produce a magnetic flux. When this magnetic flux is linked with the coil, as it is tuned for 750 kilohertz, when this flux is coming, whether this impedance or this impedance will be low, any of this impedance will be low. If we say that this impedance is low, that means this resistance is low, this reactance is a kind of resistance to AC is low. When 1000 kilohertz is coming to this point, this will be very low. So the voltage is developed across the inductor, but at that frequency the reactance of the capacitor is very low. So the voltage developed across will be flown like this. This will be flown through like this. There is no voltage or output is coming to this. So this, as the reactance of this will be low, this will be short circuited through this circuit. So no voltage is coming to this. When if we transmit at less than 600 kilohertz, when a 600 kilohertz frequency is coming, that means at a lower frequency, at that frequency this impedance will be higher and this impedance will be lower. If we move this contact to this point, the inductance, the number of turns is reduced. When the number of turns is reduced, the impedance of this will be very low. So it will produce a low voltage at that frequency. At that frequency, the voltage across this will be very low. As the voltage across this will be very low, the current to this will be very low. So if any of this impedance will be low, the output will be not coming to the crystal. If both the output are equal, then the output find a path through the crystal, then the crystal will oscillate. But the crystal has a property that its response is very low. That means at high frequency it will not be able to respond so fast. So output we will get is the message signal. Why we put this capacitor is that if we put the capacitor, the higher frequency will be, it will offer a very less reactance to the higher frequencies. So this will be gone through this, and only the envelope is coming through this. Why we put the diode? The diode is put that the signal is, this signal is the reflection of this signal. So in order to avoid any of this half, we are putting the diode so that we can get only positive or negative side. Here we are taking the positive side only. So thus, by adjusting the value of the inductance or capacitance, we can change the impedance, and so we can select a particular frequency. This is how crystal radio is working.